First of all, look, I'm out here because I love y'all. I'm out here because I want y'all to hear the truth, and I'm out here because I love y'all. Okay. I'm not this lady. Well, you have no expectation of privacy. You have no expectation of privacy. This is a public area. This is a public area. It's a public area.
Go to your side of the street.
This is a public area. We don't have a side of the street.
You don't want to be on YouTube.
So this is it. Here's their argument. Here's their argument.
Okay, well, why does it matter?
And so there's our, okay, go ahead.
Prevent and educate.
Why?
Not intimidate.
Okay, here's the thing.
And educate.
So I'm trying to, so here a student asks a question and then we have a protester.
Do not intimidate.
See what I'm saying? She won't let me answer your question.
Do not intimidate.
You see what I mean? You want to answer your question, right? Hey, he's curious. Can you let me respond to his question? Why won't you let me respond to the student? What do you have to hide?
Why are you trying?
Huh? You're intimidating. See, it's self-canceling.
Well, I'm very intimidating.
No, yeah, I mean, you're just like shouting me down. I'm trying to, okay, so look, what we have here, what we have with abortion, right, is we have a human being destroyed in the most helpless place that they're in.
Okay.
A human being. The only difference between you today and you when you were an embryo is size, level of development, environment, or degree of dependency. As a, from the embryonic stage, you're distinct, you're living in your whole. You're not part of the mother. You have metabolism. Hold on now. You have metabolism, which is what science defines as something that's growing. You have metabolism. You're your own organism, okay?
Look, are they sustainable on their own? No.
So we can kill people that are not sustainable on their own. Anybody who is not sustainable on their own, that's the standard.
Without a womb.
Okay, so now it's in the womb. Now it's bodily autonomy. Which one? We're just tossing things out. I mean, I'm willing to answer every single one of these.
No, I'm saying they're not sustainable.
Go ahead. What's your name, man?
My name is Weston.
Weston. Hey, first of all, hold on. Before you go, I want to thank you all for being out here, for being brave enough to come out here and like stand up for what you believe is right. Yeah. And I appreciate you letting me speak to you because, like, look, y'all get the secular humanism all the time. You get the statist opinion all the time. And I'm giving you the Christian worldview on this position. So go ahead. Yeah. 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 Christian. 100% Christian. Yeah. Go ahead. Yeah.
Okay. Well, my opinion is that because a fetus in the womb isn't as developed as a human, therefore they're not the same as like...
Therefore they're not a human.
As a baby, I guess. Yeah.
Okay. So it's a dehumanization argument, right? So it's level... Which point here? We have size.
Yeah.
Level of development. So size, we don't kill a smaller person because they're not as developed. Like I have a 2-year-old, I can't shoot her, right? Because she's 2. I'm not more valuable than my 2-year-old because I'm more developed, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. So size, that's not it, right? Level of development. Okay. Yeah. So it's level of development. So in other words, location. So the location of the human being. If I was inside that school, would I be more valuable than outside?
I mean, it's not the fact that...
So location, we got two out, right? Okay.
No, not arguing that.
So degree of development, degree of dependency, how about that?
Well, I wouldn't say degree of dependency.
So we don't kill the fetus, which is actually Latin for little baby, by the way, or little person, or little one, okay?
All right.
We use Latin because we want to dehumanize the unborn. Just like black people were considered property in 1857. Look, check this out. We had two Supreme Court decisions, bro. One in 1857, a 7-2 Supreme Court decision. 7-2 Supreme Court decision said that black people are slaves, property, not human.
Well,
and if you don't like
it, that's changed.
If you don't, exactly. But without the law of God, without the law of God outside, without the law of God outside, if man just determines what law is, then slavery was right for that society, right? Yeah.
Well, no. Well, I mean,
but
see, who would be a
no?
Go ahead.
But also, yeah. We're determining because this is supposed to be.
Where's that come from?
You guys are supporting this to be a law, right?
What do you mean? We're saying that abortion is lawlessness. We're saying that abortion is the same kind of lawlessness as slavery. What does that mean?
It's your choice, and I don't care. Okay, wait, hold on.
So, okay, choice to do what though?
Your choice to abort or not to abort.
But anyway,
to do anything. That's obviously not true. You know that's not true. Okay.
So you're saying you want to support making it illegal to have an abortion.
To murder, right?
Okay, sure. Good. Whatever.
No, I wasn't talking. I'm sorry. I should let you speak. I apologize. Okay. Go. I'm so sorry. Yeah.
So, and then if we're bringing God into it, and that's theology at that point. You can't bring God into law.
Well, no, actually, all laws are religious in nature. All laws. Okay, because
I get that.
Because laws determine what's ethical. Okay, so laws. It's the source of law is the God of the society. No, but so religion is just a word. Okay, religion is just a word that we use to.
Religion is just a thing that creates war as well. I mean, if you want to, hold on, let me address this.
This is good. He's on a roll. Okay. Go ahead. Yeah.
Religion into making laws, then you're going to go into so many Middle Eastern countries that are oppressed and have no freedoms.
Okay.
And, you know,
First of all, you unpacked a lot there. You unpacked a lot there, and it's those are arguments that we hear a lot, and they're very powerful in the secular community. A lot of people latch onto them. Okay, so here, first one, you can't legislate your morality. You're just bringing theology into it. So what we're saying is that all law is by nature religious because it determines what is right and wrong and just in a society.
God is, hold on, wait a second.
Justice. It's the idea of justice. The word religious is throwing you off. It's the ethics. It's the philosophy. Whatever you want to put.
I believe there's inherent goodness in humans that determine what is.
Let me push pause on this one here. Okay. And let me go right here real quick. Okay. Inherent goodness. Good according to whom? Good according to whom? Individual or culture?
According to
you said good. Good assumes an objective standard of morality.
Yes.
So if there's no God, then all you have is society determining what's good and individuals determining what's good based on collective opinion.
I think that's the argument.
The argument is what'd you say?
Morals are a part of being human.
Exactly. So there it is. They're Darwinian. Yes. So in other words, we have this illusion of morality that's been foibed off on our genes through the Darwinistic process. But that doesn't say that morality exists. That says morality doesn't exist. That says it's not objective. It's just something that's subjective.
Because it's not outside of human nature.
Okay, cool. No, this is indisputable. However, that's your position. It's Richard Dawkins, it's your position. Exactly, but majority rule. Hold on, now let me answer. If majority rule is true, okay, or if just the will of whatever society makes right, that's might makes right. So you mentioned religion causing more wars and all that other kind of stuff and more death and more carnage. What about the last 150 years of secular humanism in countries where they outlawed religion and they had mass genocides? Because anytime that you put man in the place of God, hold on now. 120 million died under regimes, communistic regimes, over the past 150 years that outlawed God and said that the source of morality in society is the will of the people. Joseph Stalin called it scientific socialism.
Well, the problem there, the problem with the government that they had.
Yeah, but it's okay. Then so the word religion's throwing you off. Say worldview.
Okay.
Right. So it's the world. Somebody's worldview is going to be enforced in law.
Naturally, yeah. Well,
okay.
I mean, but if it's a democratic society, then it's going to be the collective good of people.
Yeah, but the good is determined just by you could determine anything to be good. According to your worldview, if everyone in this world decided for the time being, let's say for 5 minutes, there was a drug that fell out of the sky and it tricked everybody's mind into thinking it was okay to rape and murder a 2-year-old. For those five minutes, it would be right. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes, however, that wouldn't happen. Because I think people,
No, but you're not dealing with hypotheticals here, though. I'm saying you have to admit, it would be right. You would have to say, so according to your worldview, as long as everyone believes it, it makes it right. No, you can't. You gotta be consistent.
That's not true. It's not everyone believes it.
Yeah.
It's the majority that believes it.
Okay, so yeah, the majority. Yeah, then it makes it right. So what Hitler did, if the majority believed it, makes it right. Come on, stand on your worldview.
It made it right in that moment.
No, I said if it's a hypothetical, okay? That's how you undress worldviews.
Here's what I think.
So it was wrong because the majority thought so. But I said, hypothetically, if everyone in the world thought that it's okay to rape and murder a 2-year-old, that doesn't make it okay. According to my worldview, according to the actual worldview of truth.
So in certain points of time, the majority of people have believed things that are wrong.
Choice.
That has happened before.
Hold on, what did this gentleman say?
Something obscene doesn't mean it's not true.
It would be legal on a legal basis, it would be right.
Rape and murder.
Not just legal, but right. And so what I'm saying,
but
I think that's the thing. If you look throughout world history, majority rule has led to some really, really disgusting things.
No, and that's the thing.
Has led to some disgusting things.
But I think it's getting better. Well, society today.
I actually agree with that.
Significantly.
I actually fully agree with that. But that doesn't actually make an argument.
Assholes, we all have one.
That doesn't make an argument. Just that society is generally getting better. According to my worldview, Christ is moving history forward.
Okay.
So that's an argument that could fit with evolution or theism.
Yes.
Okay. So it doesn't really. It's not an exclusive worldview argument on your part.
But what you're arguing is that if the majority agrees on something that is, you know, like unethical, like, you know, for example, you can steal from anyone, whatever you want.
Yeah.
If everyone agrees on that, then that's bad. But
yeah.
I think
I'm saying that that's what your worldview says.
Well, but the problem with that is that you're assuming that people are going to have that that worldview and like stick with it, and that's, you know, what people are going to continue to agree is right.
We're just talking about the nature of good. We're talking. You said good. You brought good into the.
Humans are striving towards justice. Yeah. And over time,
but justice is what I'm saying is that justice is a meaning. And you're a smart kid. You're sharp. You can think about things like this.
Yes.
Justice is a meaningless term according to your worldview.
I don't think it's meaningless.
Because we have to create it. Yeah.
Yes.
We have to create it.
Certainly.
It's shifting. There's no standard. So when you say something is just or unjust, you're saying basically that's these people's opinion versus these people's opinion. Ice cream versus, and then good for being consistent.
Mm-hmm.
Chocolate ice cream versus vanilla ice cream. I'm saying that there is a better way. I'm saying that there is a moral law giver that says that there's a reason why you know good and evil. There's a reason why you know certain things are objectively wrong, even if everyone in that school thought that they were right. That you know that they were wrong. Even if everyone in the world thought something was wrong, that you would know this is wrong. And you don't have to agree with that. You don't have to, I mean, you don't even have to. That's my statement about you.
Okay,
I mean, you could say wrong, whatever.
I don't agree, because I don't think everyone in the world is going to think that something that's wrong.
But that's a high, that's not my point.
Yeah, I know.
My point is I'm showing you, with your worldview, there is no such thing as justice. You just said justice, and justice is a concept that's subjective. According to your worldview, it's not objective. It's subject
it
to the people.
But it's improving. Yeah. It's always improving. That's why.
But improving, see, even the word improving, watch this, y'all. Yeah. Even the word improving denotes a better. It denotes a standard outside of those things.
I think in theory, eventually, it might take a long time, but I think we will get to a point where justice is objective or very close to it.
Like it can't.
The majority of people
But you're basically just saying.
Okay, let me ask you this.
Yeah.
So, 1,000 years ago, was racism okay?
Absolutely not.
Yes.
Absolutely not.
Racism
was not okay. Racism was always against the law of God.
Did the people think that, though?
A lot of people were racist, but it didn't make it okay. See, according to the law of God, racism is always not okay. According to his law, according to secular humanism, racism was okay. Say it. Racism was okay when
people
thought they were okay.
But now.
Yeah, but that made it okay then.
It didn't make it okay.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah. It was okay to them. To those people that were living at the time.
Okay, but it was okay then.
I'm not saying it's okay. I'm not saying it's justified, because now
looking at it from the viewpoint
that we have now, we realize that that's wrong.
Bro,
and we improve from that.
Bro, you're too smart for this. You just said at that time. So if we zap back
to those people, it was okay. It was okay to them.
And it was okay.
But I know you're not saying that. From our view now.
Yeah, I know you're not saying
now,
that.
From our view now, we can look back on that and say that was wrong, and we've improved from that.
Bro,
that's what I'm saying.
No, you can't prove anything because you don't have no stand. All you have is opinions now.
Because we've improved. We've improved our.
No,
our
I'd say that's in many areas. I mean, in many areas we have improved, but in a lot of areas we have not. Like, for example, now we used to murder and enslave people based on the color of their skin, and now we just do it because of their size, level of development, environment, and degree of dependency.
I think that's a logical fallacy. I think you're comparing things that are not equal.
Well, point out how it's not equal.
Okay, well, I mean,
point out. See, just saying something is that's a just so argument.
A baby can't.
But that's not the point. So they would make so many arguments pro-slavery saying that, oh, actually, you know, they made that same argument. The slaveholders actually made that same argument. If you said, wait a second,
wrong.
Hold on.
They were wrong.
But according to that, according to your worldview, they were right then.
Not according to the North.
Wait a second. It was first of all, you know, hold on now, but do you know, hold on. First of all, let me answer your question real quick. The slaveholders back in the day actually justified slavery by saying that them slaves can't survive on their own.
And they
need us.
And they
said that.
Correct.
And they said, see, they were correct?
They were incorrect.
Okay, cool, cool. Let's get that on camera. I want to represent you right, my man. I like you, man.
We're able to live on their own for a good
Y'all are willing to come out here and exchange ideas. I think this is so fabulous. Hey, y'all give them some love. They're willing to come out here and exchange their ideas, man. This is great. Like, if you see these other counter protesters, they're not willing to exchange ideas. If you have the truth, see, these are young men that think they have the truth, and they're willing to come out here and put it on display. Now, they happen to be mistaken, but they're out here willing to put it on display. Now, look, so we just showed you how that argument was also applied to slaves. They couldn't survive on their own. You said, show me how it's... And
because they're wrong. They're wrong about it. Yeah. You know? I mean, if someone's objectively wrong about something...
You can't say objectively wrong.
Using basic logic, you can determine that they are objectively wrong, you know?
You can't. Well, no.
Some things are objective.
Yeah, only because God exists. Only because God exists. Without God, you don't have objective. All you have is subject. That's the definition of secular humanism, is the subjective opinions of man determine right and wrong. And since man changes, then right and wrong has to change.
Yes.
There's no objective standard outside of man.
I think right and wrong improves.
But you have no... Improve. The word improves has no value. It has no ontological meaning distinction. The word improves doesn't mean anything.
I think people should always be trying to improve.
But according to who? The society?
So
how does the society improve?
Okay. According to the society and according to themselves. You know, according to what they believe and what people have determined is just, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, if they agree.
See, that people have determined is just. And so you brought up racism. Now, at least go ahead and straight stand on your worldview and say racism was right for those that practiced it when society thought it was right.
It was not right for them, because looking back from our worldview now, we realize that they were wrong.
So you realize that's just judging a past era by today's norms, right?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Okay, so what happens in 50 years when they look back at us?
Exactly. Yeah, I think people will look back at us now and say
we're wrong. This is wrong, right? Say slaughtering babies in the womb is wrong, right? They'd be like, look at those guys. They were fighting the fight of the 1800s.
We can't know that. We can't know that for sure, because whatever people have in 50 years, they're going to look back at us and say, you know, whatever we're believing is wrong. But whatever they're believing then is probably going to be more correct than it is now.
How are we assured of that? I mean, our ancestors are fish, right?
History's proven it.
Our ancestors are fish, right? Right? Okay, I mean, nothing exploded. Matter, energy, space, and time come to existence for no prior existing materials. Everything's just physical components, correct? It burbles up over a long period of time, and all of a sudden, me and you are talking about metaphysical concepts like justice, like love. What worldview do you think that, if you had no dog in the fight, if you were trying to look objectively on it, which worldview do you think that would line up more with? Secular humanism or Christian theism?
I think it could line up with either. I mean, it depends how you see
it. So justice can arise. Is justice a physical concept? Like, how do I put justice in a test tube and measure it? How do I put righteousness? You can't, right?
No.
But does it exist?
Well,
objectively?
Many things exist that aren't physical.
Oh, but does it objectively exist? Or is it just an invent of the human mind?
I think it objectively exists, but you can't objectively determine what it is.
Okay, but do you see that you have no basis for that statement?
And even that statement doesn't
make sense.
Well,
it objectively exists, but you can't determine what it is. Yeah. Okay, let's just take that statement.
There's a lot of things that are like that, you know? I mean,
let's take that statement on its face.
I mean, you could say that about, like, you know, aliens. Like, aliens, they probably exist, but you can't prove they exist. I mean,
they probably don't exist. The amount of, you know, fine-tuned characteristics that need to happen in order for advanced life. Aliens? You're a science person, right?
Yeah, I think aliens could exist. I think it's certainly possible.
That's neither here nor there. What we're saying is that your worldview doesn't present a standard, an outside standard. You have to admit that. I mean, at least be consistent.
Okay.
Your worldview doesn't present an outside standard. Okay?
What do you mean by outside standard?
Outside of man or culture. Man is all there is. Man is the measure. Like, if you look in the Enlightenment, hold on now. If you look in the Enlightenment, if you study the Enlightenment, the idea was man is the measure.
Okay.
That was the slogan.
Yes.
Man is the measure. Okay, so since man changes, that is the Enlightenment slogan.
Okay.
I mean, it's true.
Sure. Yeah, sure.
Okay, so if man changes, then everything that is measured by man also changes.
Okay.
If that statement is true, right?
Sure.
So if something changes all the time, right?
Yes.
There is no object. That is the definition of subjectivity, changing due to circumstances, changing due to limited individual entities. Do you see what I'm getting at here?
Yeah, okay.
So you can't superimpose an objective standard with your worldview. You have to be like Nietzsche and say basically everything outside, okay, is just a projection of man.
Okay.
All right. So there is no justice. There is an idea. Hold on now. There's an idea of justice.
Yeah. I mean, justice is an idea, you know?
But there's no, it's meaningless according to your worldview.
I don't think, no, it's not meaningless.
Yeah, okay, the okay, I'll tell you. How do you, but you, better is meaningless. See, okay, we're going around in a circle.
I think better
okay,
is, okay.
We're, we're going around in a circle. Okay, I mean, yeah. People watching can decide if you've made your argument correctly, but they also do decide that you're, I mean, this is a kid that's sharp. What's your name?
Weston.
Hey, pray for Weston, y'all. Pray in the name of Jesus that the intelligence that God has given this man is used for the glory of the kingdom. I want to give you,
thank you,
before, absolutely. No, and honestly, like, I'm not here to prove a point. I'm here because I love you, and I'm here because of what's going on in our society. You know what I mean?
Yes.
You've been extremely respectful.
Thank you.
Extremely respectful.
Yes,
and
well.
I mean, just, I mean, because I'm, I mean, you see, I'm not your enemy, man.
Yeah, no.
You know what I mean?
I certainly agree. Yeah. Discussion is very, it's very important.
Yeah, because if you have the truth, people should want it, right?
Yes.
Well, let me tell you before I leave that Jesus, the creator of the universe, the second person of the Christian Trinity, died for your sins because you know that there is a justice and you know that there is the standard. Even if you won't admit it, you know that there's a standard outside of man and you know that mankind violates that standard. And so Jesus, so you don't have to pay the penalty of separation from a righteous God, died for your sins on a cross in Jerusalem back in the first half of the first century as the pinnacle of the story of history, rose from the grave, pours out the Spirit, and calls you to say, anyone who calls upon my name will be saved. That is the gospel that I preach to you today. My name is Joe Salant.